This tutorial is brought to you by Envato Elements, your source to download millions of assets for all your creative projects. Hello and welcome to... Happy to see you here and I hope you do well. Today we've got a short and simple tutorial on the menu. It's a fun and easy effect that I recently learned and wanted to share with you guys. Have you ever heard about a star filter? Well, star filters are just like ND filters that can be screwed onto your lens. A star filter adds a glowy star effect onto your image. On the Hoya website, you can see exactly what I mean. And by the way, this effect also reminds me a bit of the way that the TV looked back in the 80s. Anyway, in this tutorial, we're going to recreate this look onto our footage inside Adobe Premiere Pro. And we're not going to use a star filter, but instead we'll use some built-in effects of Premiere Pro. As I mentioned, it's really simple, so let's jump over to Premiere and I'll show you how it's done. Inside Premiere, we've already got a clip on the timeline. In the first step, I'm going to duplicate the clip two times. You can do this by holding the Alt key combined with the left mouse button and then drag the clip up to the next track above the other one. In the next steps, I'm going to blend the clips. First, I'll select the clip on top and then head over to the Effects Control Panel. In here, I'm going to lower the opacity and I usually start with somewhere around 66%, but you can tweak this later on if needed. Next, I'll select the clip in the middle and then change the blend mode. Depending on the type of footage, I usually choose screen. But if it's a little darker, like this one, I like to choose a lighten. And the same applies to the bottom clip. I'm also going to set this one to lighten. In the next steps, we're going to apply an effect. In the effects panel, we're going to search for the directional blur effect. You can find this one under video effects, blur and sharpen. And I will apply this one to the bottom and middle track. Then I'll select the middle track or clip and then go to the effects control panel. In there, I'll change a couple of settings for the directional blur effect. First, I'll set direction to 45 degrees and I will also change the blur length. In this case, somewhere around 50 will be fine. And by the way, you can see the results directly here in the program monitor, so you can play around with the numbers to see what fits best on your footage. Next, I will select the bottom video track and then set direction to minus 45 degrees and also increase the blur length. If I scrub to the timeline, you can see the results of what I've done so far. As I mentioned before, you can play around with the opacity of the top clip if you think that there's too much blur going on. So this way you can make the top clip more or less transparent. Another option would be to do some basic color corrections inside the Lumetri color panel. One of the first sliders that I like to use is contrast. And besides that, I will also use highlights and shadows. But of course, every scene requires some different settings. So I would recommend to play around with the sliders until you get the look that you're going for. And that is how you create a star filter look inside Adobe Premiere Pro. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And if you did, then please like the video. I would really appreciate that. Anyway, thanks again for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.